dry brushing is an ancient art. They found across the board internationally that people who live to be 100 years and older with full quality of lives all did certain things. Sunlight, fresh air, water was their main fluid, got out in the garden, it grounded with the earth, ate their fresh garden greens and produce, and all of them did dry brushing. So then in our scientists and researchers were, why the skin? Why dry brushing? And what they found was that, yes, it does remove the dead layers of skin, which clog the pores, and increases circulation, gets the circulation going, moves the outer lymph, which is just underneath the layers of skin, up to the surface, your first line of defense to anything that the skin comes in contact with in your environment. It also activates nerve ending proprioceptors. So you know how when you were in grade school and you had that teacher who was like, she must have eyes behind her head because she knows everything. Well, guess what? That is those nerve ending proprioceptors, communication centers from our skin, sending us information to the inside. So these cultures would drink a gallon of water versus flooding our bodies with gallons of water. So instead of washing the outside and leaving the inside dirty, they would dry brush, do all those wonderful things for the skin, and then drink their water on the inside, cleansing the inside, because the skin is the largest eliminating organ, moving that toxic waste out through the skin. And when your skin is clean and no longer has the soap and perspiration and all the lotions that we throw on it after washing it with water and soap scum that stays on there clogging the pores, then we need the lotion because the dry skin's still on there. So they found that by cleaning the inside, save gallons of water, drink your water, move the toxic waste out through the largest eliminating organ of the body, and our skin can breathe. It actually breathes for us when it's clean. Enjoy.
Wow, that's great. So what type of brush do you recommend? And, you know, I remember when I was a kid at a health food store, they had loofah sponges. Yeah, we use those in the shower, but they can be used as dry brushes too, right?
True.
Okay.
Yes. So an all-natural bristle brush works great. Also, people who lived by the ocean and still do, and us, get sea salt scrubs and loofahs, which is another form of dry brushing. And remember to do your hair. Our grandmas told us to brush our hair 100 strokes, it'd be clean and healthy. That also brings the circulation up to your brain, mental focus, your hearing, and your eyesight. So dry brush by brushing your hair also on the head, but don't leave the rest of the body out.
So do you recommend maybe foregoing a shower once in a while? Like, do you personally shower every day, or do you dry brush and then shower only alternate days, or what do you recommend?
If I'm not out digging in the dirt in the garden or chopping firewood or throwing hay around where I'm getting all dusty and dirty, dry brushing works efficiently while drinking your water internally to flush the systems and be clean on the inside and the out.
What do you personally recommend?
And when you get to be more in your senior years, as I am, your skin does get drier.
Yeah.
And so you want to remove the dead layers. And the dry brushing is effective versus drying it out more with water, keeping that environment.
And nowadays, a lot of our water is treated to the point where it's not like Mother Nature water. it's denatured with chlorine, and then if we're in hot tubs, other things too.
That you're breathing in and you're actually taking in through the skin. So when I travel, I dry brush more and bathe less. And the old-fashioned way was, you know, you had a bowl and a pitcher and you poured the water in. And yes, I wash my hands constantly. And I do wash my face, yet I also dry brush it. And you wash the parts of the body that need it and leave the whole shower with the toxic waters to where you're not breathing in all those chemicals and taking it in through your skin, correct?
Great. Well, thank you. This is very enlightening, very important, and awesome teaching.